class of 2020. I'm so excited to join you and your loved ones in celebrating this important milestone in your lives, and what I'm confident will be one of many important milestones to come. This day is the culmination of a great deal of hard work, commitment, focus, and dedication on your part, as well as that of your many supporters. Just to be clear, I hope you know that you didn't get here today all on your own. You know that, right? Right? Well, if you truly know that, then I encourage you to join me as we celebrate those members of your village who have been there for you all along the way. Now, I know that you probably don't have all of your many supporters right there with you to celebrate in person. Family, friends, your neighbors, your church members, or even your current and former teachers and administrators. This pandemic has impacted our lives in many, many ways, and not the least of which is the impact on your graduation experiences. But I hope that you can feel their love and support, even from a distance. Yes, this graduation experience is different, unprecedented, and will be remembered for a very long time. But I hope you'll also remember and wear your triumph today as a badge of honor and as a bit of a testimony that you are indeed a survivor. As the superintendent of Jackson Public Schools, one of my favorite experiences is to greet our graduates during these ceremonies, to shake your hands as you walk across the stage, and to say a few quick words of encouragement to you. I'm terribly disappointed that we won't have that last exchange before you leave us. But it is my sincere hope that the things that I say to you today will still prick your hearts and that they will get into the recesses of your minds to fuel you as you continue on life's journey. What typically happens in these ceremonies is that some old person stands here and gives you all of this advice and all these things that they want you to remember for the rest of your lives. Well, oftentimes they don't even know you and they certainly don't know your story, but they try to say something that's generic enough to apply to everyone, yet appropriate enough to matter to each of you individually. Well, I'm going to try to break that mold today and give you something that you can actually use. I have a few key messages bound up in two brief but powerful quotes. The first quote is this: effort is the value that we place on our wants. And I'll say that again. Effort is the value that we place on our wants. But what does that mean? Well, for me, there are a few big messages and lessons to be learned from that quote. One lesson here is that whatever you want out of life, you've got to put in the work. You have to get in there and work like you won't eat if you don't make it happen. How many of you have seen people on social media who seem to have it all? They've got the great clothes and a nice car, and maybe they're out there with their friends just enjoying life. Maybe they have a hot girlfriend or boyfriend, and on social media they seem to be living their best life, and just maybe they're doing it big in real life as well. Maybe. Well, that's fine. I've never been one to begrudge the next person for all of their fortunes. Hey, if you've got it, then I want to celebrate you. But the challenge is for us not to spend all of our time wanting what we don't have. I said the challenge for us is not to spend all of our time wanting those things that we don't have. If you really want it, then put in the work. Again, effort is the value that we place on our wants. And so if you truly want something, if you truly value it, then you must put in the effective effort to achieve and attain it. There are no shortcuts in life. That effort, by the way, should be attached to a strong plan. When you decide what it is that you really want out of life, don't just run out there and start doing things. Chart a course. Make a plan. Figure out how you'll get from here to there. And share your plan with others, because Those folks who have done something or experienced some things that could help you, they need to know it and be accountability partners for you. I've participated in dozens of these graduation ceremonies in my career, and I can't tell you how many young people come across this stage and don't have a clue what they're going to do next. Well, listen, if that happens to be you right now, then I urge you to start today charting a course, creating a plan for your life. You're going to need it. The second quote is this, and it was actually shared with me by one of my many mentors. It reads, "He who truly knows has no need to shout." And this is a quote by Leonardo da Vinci, famous painter. As you transition into your adult lives, whether you continue on to college or military, trade school, starting your own business, or even backpacking across the continent of Africa, I urge you to continue your education. You've had the benefit of a compulsory education for most of your lives. Now that you have the option of what and how and when you'll learn, I do hope that you'll be very intentional about it. Identify the things that you'll need to know in order to build your career, to develop the relationships that you want in life, to live the spiritual life that you want, to build and manage your wealth, and to be personally fulfilled. Then go out and intentionally learn what you need to know. Ladies and gentlemen, there is no life that you can live without continuing to grow your brain and learning what you need to know in order to be successful in life. Again, I say, there are no shortcuts. Do all that you can to learn all that you can, whether that's formally or informally. It is up to you. It's up to you to chart your course. It's up to you to learn and gain the skills that you need along the way. And it's up to you to make it happen for you, for your families, and for your communities. To the class of 2020, we love you. We're excited about the future and what it holds for each and every one of you. And we know that you'll make yourselves proud and all of us in the meantime. Thank you so much for being such amazing young people. Thank you in advance for all that you'll do to save and to serve the world. We love you again, and we wish you nothing but the best in your future. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Good afternoon to Superintendent Green, JPS administrators, and Board of Trustees, Principal Hampton, faculty, staff, family, friends, and guests. I am elated to stand before you today. Today is not a traditional day, but it's our day. On behalf of Forest Hill High School, also known as the University of South Jackson, welcome to the Class of 2020 Commencement Ceremony. To my fellow classmates, who have all worked so diligently over the years, I would like to congratulate you all on your accomplishments. High school has been an unforgettable journey that has prepared us for the future and what it may hold. I am filled with excitement and anticipation as the next stage of our lives unveil, as we gather here this afternoon to celebrate the class of 2020. I would like for you to reflect as I share these powerful words from the great First Lady, Michelle Obama. You may not always have a comfortable life, and you will not always be able to solve all of the world's problems at once, but don't ever underestimate the importance you can have, because history has shown us that courage can be contagious and hope can take on a life of its own. Never lose hope through the toughest moments on your way to success, because the end result will give you an extraordinary fulfillment. It's been an honor to be among such accomplished individuals and a privilege to serve as your 2019-2020 Miss Forest Hill. Thank you and best wishes.
Good afternoon to Superintendent Green and his cabinet, Principal Hampton, Assistant Principals Brown, Terry, and Smith, teachers, faculty, friends, family, and most importantly, my fellow classmates of 2020. I am humbled and honored to serve as the salutatorian of the Forest Hill Class of 2020. First, I would like to thank God, for without him, none of this would be possible. And to my wonderful parents, thank you for instilling a firm educational foundation within me. And also, thanks to my lovely sisters for setting a great example for me to follow. And now, graduation. Graduation is a day that some of us have been anticipating since the first day we became scholars at Forest Hill. During those wonderful years, we've experienced good and bad times. Like now, we are facing a huge obstacle, the inability to convene and fellowship in the traditional sense. I commend my fellow scholars for holding their heads high during this pandemic. I encourage each of you to view this as a blessing within a lesson. The lesson is family still matters. We have gotten away from our families. I know that this graduation is not traditional, but we should still be thankful for this moment to share the big milestone we completed in life. The great Maya Angelou once said, "Life is not measured by the number of breaths we take, but by the moments that take our breath away." Before I bid you farewell, I would like to leave you with a few life tips. Life is not always fair. Move forward. If you want to change the world, get over being a sugar cookie and keep moving forward. Step up when times are tough. If you want to change the world, you must be your very best in the darkest moments. Lastly, never give up. If you want to change the world, do not throw in the towel. And remember, we're the best. We're better than the rest. We are the mighty, mighty Patriots.
Good afternoon to our superintendent, Dr. Green, JPS administrators, JPS Board of Trustees, Principal Hampton, faculty, staff, and especially the graduating class of 2020. I am Victoria Page Harrison, and it is my humbling honor to represent this distinguished class as your valedictorian. First and foremost, I would like to take the time to thank God for giving me this opportunity to be here today. He has given me the willpower and courage to strive academically and spiritually as I developed into the young lady I am. Standing here before you all today, I just can't seem to wrap my head around how quickly these 4 years have passed us by. I remember my first day as a freshman running around through the vast crowds of people struggling to reach my next class thinking, this isn't how I pictured it. As time went on, I learned my way around and it all became much easier. And look at me now, I made it successfully. I would like to use that situation as a lesson. We are now young adults ready to enter the real world. Stepping out into adulthood will mostly feel just like the first day of high school, which is a mixture of scary and confusing thoughts and feelings. Even if you are feeling scared or confused, remember, as time goes on, you'll learn your way. You will make a distinct path for yourself and be well on the journey to success. Maya Angelou once stated, "Success is liking yourself, liking what you do, and liking how you do it." Graduates, as we transition into the real world, I want you all to know your success starts with you. You are your biggest opponent in life. Take it upon yourself to turn can't into I can, won't into I will, and never take no for an answer. My dear classmates, I want you to cherish the memories of walking down the halls, having fun, and especially remember the hard work you put in to be here today. Congratulations, you earned it. As you sit here today, think of your lifelong dreams and prepare to accomplish them. Regardless of your dream, be the best in whatever profession you choose. Whatever you do in life, don't just like it, love it, because the more you do what you love, the more successful you will be in life. As I close, I would like to thank the faculty and staff of Forest Hill High School. I would like to give a shout out to my favorite teachers and counselors. Ms. Rankin, thank you for showing me that learning about psychology and US government wasn't so boring after all. I will miss our CNN 10 videos with Carl Azuz and you laughing at his corny jokes. Mrs. Ketchings, since the day we met, you have been keeping me on the right path. You always make sure to check in on me, even though I am no longer in your class. I'm glad I had the opportunity to use your ACT strategies in the real world. Mrs. Cheeks, Mrs. Samuels, and Mrs. Henderson, thank you for always reassuring me and my comrades, giving a shoulder to cry on, and giving the pep talks we needed. I will especially miss being an office worker, running errands, and getting things done for you all. Mrs. Collins, I never really thought that learning a second language would be so easy. Thank you for teaching me that an open mind would prepare me for anything. Mr. Robinson, even though he is no longer a part of Forest Hill, he taught me daily life lessons that shaped me into the individual I am today. Thank you, teachers and administrators, for bearing with us even though we may have rebelled. Thank you, families, for shaping these beautiful, bright-minded individuals sitting here before you. I would like to give a special thank you to my mom and dad for always believing in me and being there to support me. I can't find the words to express how truly grateful I am for you both. Lastly, to the class of 2020, it has been an honor taking this ride with you all. Thank you so much for an amazing 4 years. This graduation is definitely not our end goal. It is only the beginning to a much larger journey. See you at the next stop. God bless.
To Dr. Green, Superintendent, Jackson Public School District Board of Trustees, Ms. Marsha Thomas, Assistant Superintendent of High Schools, parents, guardians, family, friends, faculty, staff, and most of all, the graduating seniors of the historic class of 2020 of Forest Hill High School, also known as the University of South Jackson. Before addressing my senior scholars, special thanks goes out to the school community, various alumni members and civic organizations that rose to the challenge during these uncertain times. To the other high school principals and Ms. Thomas, thank you for your leadership and outstanding understanding during the planning stages of this event. Today, under unusual circumstances, I welcome you to the class of 2020's graduation ceremony. While these are unusual circumstances, the significance of your accomplishments are absolute. Scholars, I would give almost anything to be giving this speech before you in person, but due to this pandemic, that will not happen. Not being able to see your reaction when something that is said hits you directly in the face because you know it was directed to you is priceless. I want you to bear with me for a moment while we go back to August 2018. You guys were juniors sitting in the auditorium while I was attempting to introduce myself, and that was the first time I spoke to you about All Hands on Deck. You enjoyed pep rallies, dances, various programs. You were introduced to the 21 and 25 and up club, the band incident, soccer boys advancing to the state playoffs, our boys basketball team state title run, the Coliseum Fire, extracurricular excellence in our art program, improved academic scores, a very competitive race for Mr. and Miss Forest Hill, and the close of your junior year. Fast forward to August 2019. You experienced a renewed focus, a lot of staff room changes, excellent ratings in choir and band, football team making the playoffs for the first time in more than 10 years, girls basketball advancing to the state playoffs, boys making their third straight trip to the Coliseum, having to travel to different gyms in the city to practice and play games. Then we had spring break, and then came COVID-19. You experienced uncertainty because you were wondering, would you ever return back to school? How would you complete assignments if you didn't have the technology? Do I have to stay at home? And you had a feeling of failure. In the words of one of your senior teachers, you were born for this. Your place in the history of the University of South Jackson will be cemented because of the way you were knocked down. But I'm here today to inform you that those uneasy feelings of failure are the starting line to the finish line of success. Rock bottom will always be a gateway to your individual success. Each day I spoke to you about doing the right thing and treating others with respect. Because if you don't, your ego gets into the way. Ego is the anesthesia that deadens the pain of stupidity, and pride is the burden of a foolish person. Wisdom will come to you, but you have to be open to it. Shoot for the stars, whether it is going to college, enlisting in the military, starting your own business, or moving directly into the workforce. The faculty and staff of Forest Hill High School will always be here for you. That is the premise that All Hands on Deck is about. Good enough isn't good enough if it can be better, and better isn't good enough if it can be best. Remember my story. If a young boy who grew up in the Mississippi Delta, who chopped cotton as a 12 and 13 year old, had two children by the time I was 19 years old, can stand here today as your principal, then you can do whatever you set your mind to. I love each and every one of them, regardless of how many times you were corrected, redirected, and given that look, you must have lost your mind. All of that was because it was my job to ensure that you represented your parents, guardians, your teachers, your school, and most importantly, yourself in the best way possible each and every day. And remember, we're the best, we're better than the rest, we are the mighty, mighty Patriots. Congratulations, graduates. As the principal of Forest Hill High School, I certify that these students have met the requirements as prescribed by the Board of Trustees of the Jackson Public School District and the State of Mississippi, as hereby presented to you for the award of diploma certificates. Will the class of 2020 please come forward to receive your diplomas and certificates?
Valedictorian Victoria Harrison. Victoria, a dual credit scholar, is a member of the Foreign Language Club, National Honor Society, National Beta Club, and Royal Court. Salutatorian, Courtney Sutton. Courtney, a dual credit scholar, is a member of the Foreign Language Club, National Honor Society, National Beta Club, and DECA. Number three in the class, scholar Brianna Collins. Brianna, a dual credit scholar, is a member of the Foreign Language Club, National Honor Society, National Beta Club, Art Club, Mu Alpha Theta, Book Club, Drama Club, ACT Club, Yearbook, and DECA. Number four, scholar Jocelyn Reese. Jocelyn, a dual credit scholar, is a member of the Foreign Language Club, National Honor Society, National Beta Club, Art Club, and Mu Alpha Theta. Number six, scholar Natanya Evans. Natanya, a dual credit scholar, is a member of the Foreign Language Club. Number seven, scholar Haley Singleton. Haley, a dual credit scholar, is a member of the National Honor Society and National Beta Club. Number 10, scholar Latez Ward Jr. Latez, a dual credit scholar, is a member of Foreign Language Club, National Honor Society, National Beta Club, and the ACT 21 and Up and Club. Number eight, scholar Alexis Banks. Alexis, an APAC scholar, is a member of Foreign Language Club, National Honor Society, and National Beta Club. Number five, scholar Ayana Smith. Ayana, a dual credit scholar, is a member of the National Beta Club, National Honor Society, and a member of the girls' basketball team. Scholar Brianna Banks, honors. Talaysha M. Brown, honors. Centoria R. Brown, honors. Asia S. Jordan, honors. Shakayla L. Christopher, honors. Keiston M. Sanders, honors. Mr. Forest Hill, Jaquarius L. Moore, honors. AC L. Lewis, honors. Travis D. Adams, honors. Makira Foreman, honors. Alfonso R. Johnson, Jr., honors. Jalen J. Evans, honors. Madison C. Johnson, honors. Larry Williams, Jr., honors. Number 9, scholar, Debriana Kelly. Debriana, an APAC scholar, is a member of the Foreign Language Club. Kayla L. Gibson, honors. Marquez D. Townsend, honors. Adriana A. Wilson, honors. Miss Forest Hill, Sydney Z. Howard, honors. Alexis Dunbar, honors. Aaliyah S. Manuel, honors. Lamaria T. Batty, honors. Alexis S. Davis, honors. Edgardo Urbana Arella, honors. Carlin D. Rogers, honors. Tatiana M. Jenkins, honors. Miracle L. Johnson, honors. Monasha L. Billups, honors. Janiyah Z. Fair, honors. Marquavius L. Odie, honors. Aaliyah S. Westbrook, honors. Shania N. Fields, honors. Nancy Trejo, honors. Cameron D. Lofton, honors. LaPatrick Allen. Ronisha F. Brown. Jordan A. Sumler, honors. Takora A. Bell. Rashad J. Barnes. Trenice L. Collins, honors. Tyreek M. Carter. Tiandra J. Cable. Destiny A. Dixon. Jamayan Daniels. Laquavian D. Armand. Ariana F. Courtney. You take it off. Rashard L. Alexander. Raheem Clay. Jasmine S. Burns. Love Evan J. Butler. Shadarius K. Butler. Damonte C. Andrews. Jordan L. Bailey, honors. Rashawn C. Cavett. Trevion Bass. Allen M. Duncan. Michaela S. Calvin. Jalen D. Calvin. Deron J. Chrisman. Takia A. Coleman. Shatira D. Davis. Alasia J. Dove. Aaron L. Davenport. Demontarius Q. Bolton. Jamarick J. Banks. Taisha L. Dennis McGee. Krishana J. Blackman. Jalacia A. Broom. Jalen J. Dennis. Kataja J. Brown. Alvin Brown III. Daryl E. Brown. DeAndre M. Hopkins, honors. Angel R. Hall. Gabriel A. King. Abigail E. Davis. Isabel N. Guevara. Morgan S. Howard. Fabian Gibson. Destiny J. Banks. Aaliyah A. Burns. Tayana Johnson. Megan S. Howard. Amaya A. Jackson. James E. Johnson, Jr. J. Brianna N. Knight. Kadarius R. Funches. Cornelius C. Greer. Jacoby D. Gibson. LaMercer D. Holland. Dorian T. Christmas. Treasure L. Hill. Brandon J. Gibbs. Anton D. Ellis. Alea J. Knight. Khalil J. Foster. Anton R. Felson. Christopher D. Hughes. Jalen M. Henderson, honors. Aniqua N. Hollins. Cambriel D. Burge. Taisha L. Funches. Marviana L. Eubanks. Mario Jackson. Joya S. Hughes. Tyler S. Hudson. Joshua D. Johnson. Kaderica D. Johnson. Michael D. Johnson, Jr. Dalen M. Galloway. DeCoria D. Kelly. Denisha R. Grant. Naya Gilbert. Jason J. Johnson. Shayla J. Edwards. Aaron M. Hutton. Trishandria L. Jones. Tiana R. Howard, honors. Crystalline L. Sheriff. Devarius D. Johnson. Micah Lee, honors. Trayvon N. McClinton. Quenisha M. Silas. Christopher T. Lloyd, honors. Christian T. Moncrief. Gabrielle M. Page. Taylor N. Palmer. Aja D. Liddell. Kendall K. Mason. Tiana L. Powell. Jalen D. Rand. Xavier N. Lee. Jillian Magruder. Tatiana M. Lowry. Shania K. Lee. Jonathan M. McWilliams. Jonathan A. Rhodes. Xavier R. McAdory. Delisa S. Osborne. Tiara N. McGee. Asia M. Rhodes. Zaniah A. Scott. Xavion M. Montgomery. Keandre J. Montgomery. Terrence K. McGraw, Jr. Talia K. McGraw. William R. McCullum. Leo McIntyre III. Michaela K. Rollins. Antoine D. LaFleur. Reginald D. McGowan. Shantae L. Sanders. Henry C. Sanders. Asia M. Marco. Tatiana L. Meeks. Micaiah L. Quick. Samaya T. Shelby, honors. Devaris D. Sheriff. Darlicia A. Williams. William B. Sampson. Jamisha L. Simmons. Kamari M. Williams. Shakira T. Smith. K. Kimaya Welch. Ashanti M. Smith. Destiny Wilson. Quintavious C. Winters. Shekinah L. Williams. Cameron B. Taylor. Amir T. Ward. James S. Thompson, Jr. Shamilia J. Taylor, honors. Quindarius T. Willis. Deja R. Williams. Jakayla A. Williams. Devante I. Moore. Zoe C. Smith. Victor R. Simmons. Quindarius D. Sorrell. Tashambi J. Taylor. Damian C. Ward. Kobe T. Roberts. Monterans L. Timms. Ashanti N. Thomas. Makiba S. Williams. Jameson E. Terry. Brian K. Taylor. Jadarius Wilson. Davion K. Luckett. Shanice B. Strahan. Emmanuel Russell. Derek J. Wilson, Jr. Xavier D. Washington. Michael W. Thomas, Jr.
Ms. Washington.
Sydney M. Tucker. Jalen N. Talton. Latasia Ward. Mayana A. Stapleton. Keelan J. Unger. Diamond Stewart. Alexis L. Weathersby. Charles S. Spann. Jalen T. Winters. Micaiah S. Spires. Quentin H. Young. Kiana Jackson. Adam L. Trader. Mario G. Martin. Michael T. Ransberg. Jemiah S. Lewis. Deshauna M. Gooch, Honors.
To the class of 2020, you are our greatest generation. We look to you for courage, strength, and innovation. We have no doubt you will exceed our every expectation. This is why we are honored to confer to you your diplomas. By the authority vested in us, by the Board of Trustees of the Jackson Public School District, we attest that the certificates and diplomas that have been presented to you indicate the satisfactory completion of your public school education. It is now our privilege to confer your diplomas and extend all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. Congratulations to each of you. Graduates, you may move your tassels.